Okay, hi, assalamualaikum. We are from L0131. Okay, now we want to show you about our mini project, which is to operate the bubble cat distillation column. So, let's enjoy.
What is a distillation? Distillation process is a process to separate between different components at a different condition, which is mean in this experiment we need to separate between liquid and vapor at a different boiling point. So when the different boiling points, if the distance of the boiling points of the liquid and vapor is higher or further, the separation process will become easier. But the separation process will become harder when the distance of the liquid and vapor of the boiling point become shorter, which is mean you need to make a redistillation process until you achieve the good distillation process. So next I will tell you about the bubble cap tray. There's a lot of many of tray in the world, which is sieve tray, trap trays, and bubble cap trays. So I will tell you about the bubble cap tray. Each bubble cap tray has a chimney on each bubble cap tray. So here's the process of the bubble cap trays. Here's the gap and here's the riser, and the vapor come from the bottom. For the cap, there's a space between cap and the riser. So the vapor will come from the bottom and will go to the top and go to the cap, and the liquid will go to down and then go out from the cap. So those liquid that come from the outside will become bubble through the liquid. So the advantage of the bubble cap tray is a large standard ratio, which is it can change from highest flow rate to the lowest flow rate.
Okay, the higher of the flow ratio means the more vapor liquid contact can occur in the distillation column. So the higher reflux ratio usually means that the higher of purity of the distillate. It also means that the collection rate for the distillate will be slower. When the reflux ratio increase, the number of theoretical stage will decrease because ROL and SRL of the graph will rotate downward. The area between the equilibrium curve and ROL is become larger and can make the larger triangle between the operating lines. So that means there are now greater driving force for the separation. That turn the less number of theoretical stage are required.
Okay, before you run this experiment, you have to prepare 30 liter of mixture, ethanol and also the ionized water. Okay, before that, you have to make sure that valve or V4 and V5 are totally closed, and V10, V2 and V8 are open. This is a valve of V8, and then you can slowly open the cooling water to supply to the condenser after it reach to 6 liter per minute. It is flow rate, alright? After that, you can open the valve of VC and fill the mixture into the reboiler. So here you can see this is already filled into the reboiler. So after that, you can open the main power supply and open the power of electrical and open on the heater. After that, you can adjust the volt around to 230 volt. Use this control. When the mixture is start to reboil, we have to make sure that we have to close the V2, right? Okay, so if for the experiment we want to get the ratio 1.0, we have to make sure that reflux control of both leading is 1:1, but it just here. And then after that, we can observe the temperature at 214. And if the temperature is reached to 90 degrees, we have to slowly adjust the atmosphere. It 20 to cooling down the temperature. Then we can collect the product at V5 and V4 every 5 minutes in the experiment.
Found here 1, 2,
from the jar, you get this six space equal to six. So that's all.
Okay. As a conclusion, each bubble cap has many slot and each tree has many bubble cap to up the vapor. Okay. This ensure maximum contact between vapor and liquid and also ensure the maximum of mass transfer between liquid and vapor. Based on the data obtained, the refractive index for top and the bottom was analyzed. Then the top product was ethanol while the bottom product was water. The type obtained for the vapor liquid suspension of ethanol water mixture can be considered a reasonable, reliable method.